Hello students, welcome to the session continuation of GI disorders. Today we talk about malabsorption syndrome. Malabsorption syndrome is mainly characterized by impaired intestinal absorption of nutrients, especially of fat. Some other substances are proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. There are two types of malabsorption syndrome. One is primary malabsorption syndrome and secondary malabsorption syndrome. In primary malabsorption syndrome, mainly due to primary deficiency of the absorptive mucosal surface and of the associated enzymes. In case of secondary malabsorption syndrome, mucosal changes results secondary to other factors such as any diseases or infection, surgery to the part of the intestine or trauma and drugs. Drugs, mainly the antibiotics, will play a major role, and even some of the antipsychotic drugs. Clinical features, mainly the person will have steatorrhea, that is passage of fat or foul smelling stool along with the stool, or even sometimes the bulk of the stool will be increased with the pale in color. Chronic diarrhea also will be associated, then abdominal distension, then flatulence, anorexia, there is a aversion towards the intake of any kind of food, even weight loss, muscle wasting, dehydration, hypotension. Because of the dehydration, there is a drop in the blood pressure, then specific malnutrition and vitamin deficiencies depending upon the cause. Investigations, mainly the laboratory test, can rule out the malabsorption syndrome, and intestinal mucosal biopsy. This gives the important idea regarding the which kind of specific nutrients are deficiency. There will be a Villus atrophy, variable degree of flattening of the intestinal mucosa, mainly seen in malabsorption syndrome. It is the commonest pathological change in mucosal pattern and is referred to as Villus atrophy. There will be a partial Villus atrophy, and here what will happen, there is a mild form of lesion in which villi fuse with each other and thus become very short and broad. So the length of the intestine here will be very short due to the fusion of the villi, and they become broad, the enlargement of the intestine takes place. So it is mainly commonly found in children and adults with diarrhea or parasitic infestations, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, and malabsorption due to drugs and even radiation therapy, mainly the radiation which gives for treating the any cancerous stages. Then one more condition, subtotal or total villus atrophy, is the severe form of lesion in which there is flattening of mucosa due to more advanced villus fusion. One more condition, that is celiac sprue. This is the most important cause of primary malabsorption occurring in temperate climates. The condition is mainly characterized by significant loss of villi in the small intestine and diminished absorptive surface area. There are two forms, one is childhood form and adult form. In childhood form, mainly seen in the infants and children, and is commonly referred to as celiac disease. Adult form in adolescents and in early adult life, and used to be called as idiopathic steatorrhea. Steatorrhea is nothing but there is a passage of the stool, a fat in the stool. In either case, there is genetic abnormality resulting in sensitivity to gluten, gliadin. It is one of the protein commonly found in wheat, barley and whey proteins, and its derivatives, mainly the gliadin, present in the diets such as grains of wheat, barley and rye. The symptoms are usually revealed on elimination of gluten from the diet. Hypersensitivity reaction as seen by gluten stimulated antibodies. Histologically, there are no differences in the pathological findings in children and adults. There is variable degree of flattening of the mucosa, particularly of the upper jejunum, and to small extent of duodenum and ileum. There is one more condition called as tropical sprue. This disease, as the name suggests, occurs in individual living in or visiting to tropical areas such as Caribbean countries, South India, Sri Lanka and Hong Kong, mainly in Asia. Pathogenesis of the condition is not clear, but there is an evidence to support enterotoxin production by some strains of E. coli, Escherichia coli, which causes the intestinal injury. Severe cases are characterized by additional features such as macrocytic anemia, glossitis, and emaciation due to intestinal malabsorption of vitamin B12 and folate. Histologically, there is usually partial villus atrophy and sometimes subtotal atrophy of the villus can be seen. The lesions are relieved by removal of the patient from the tropical area and by oral administration of antibiotics to treat the any infections. There is one more condition that is called as congenital megacolon. As the name says, it is one of the hereditary factor. The term megacolon is used for any form of marked dilatation of the entire colon or its segments. Mainly occurs as a congenital or acquired disorder. Congenitally is characterized by congenital absence of ganglion cells in the bowel wall. It's called as Hirschsprung's disease. So the aganglionic segments remains contracted. Clinically, the condition manifests shortly after birth with constipation, gaseous distension, and sometimes with acute intestinal problems. 1 in 5,000 live births has familial tendency in about 4% of the cases, mainly seen in Down syndrome. Morphological features: full thickness rectal biopsy and suction biopsy that includes mucosa and submucosa for mainly to rule out whether the problem is intact or not. Grossly, two segments should be seen in this condition: a distal narrow segment that is aganglionic and a dilated proximal segment that contains normal number of ganglionic cells. Microscopically, the distal narrow segment shows total absence of ganglion cells of all the three flexes, mainly Ortsbach or meientric plexus, deep submucosal or Ehlers plexus, superficial mucosal or Meissner's plexus. Acquired causes mainly obstructive, example due to trauma or post-inflammatory strictures. Endocrine causes mainly in case of myxedema or cretinism. CNS disorders, example like spina bifida or paraplegia, even Parkinsonism. Psychogenic, example emotional disturbances or psychiatric disorders. Thank you.